Hello mate. Just because your patient's denture is retained by implants doesn't mean you shouldn't understand how to set denture teeth. Mandibular occlusion is easy to do, as this video will demonstrate. You can use just about any teeth. And waxing a denture doesn't require the services of one of the old masters. Earlier, Mr. Cooper questioned why dentists should set teeth. My reply was that the best way to learn was to actually set a few. That way you're in a position to adequately evaluate the laboratory service that you're paying for. In an earlier video, we demonstrated how to set the anterior teeth. In this video we'll show you how to set up the mandibular posterior. As you might expect, a few caveats need to be mentioned. The video demonstrates tooth setting on a school teaching model. Students were given specific guidance on how to construct the wax rims. Teeth were set on a flat plane. And a 5-degree inclination of the guide table was employed to account for an inaccuracy in the use of the mounting table. Here's what the setup looks like. Let's go over some of the basics of this particular lingualized setup. One really important concept to understand is freedom in centric. The case is mounted on the cast with a retruded jaw relationship. We will set the condylar inclination at 0, as well as the lateral at 0. The cast is mounted with a flat mounting table. If we then restrict the patient to this position with our tooth arrangement, the patient typically will complain of not being able to wear the denture. So, in the anterior we set the teeth with no vertical overlap, and about 1 mm of horizontal overjet. The anterior teeth will exhibit only brushing contact in excursions. They should be able to bite a piece of lettuce. The mandibular teeth are usually monoplane or semi-anatomic. The teeth are set on the middle of the ridge, with the entire occlusal surface flat against the maxillary occlusal plane. Landmarks are placed on the cast, denoting the middle of the ridge. Position of the cuspid and the retromolar pad. The retromolar pad is divided into thirds. The mandibular occlusal plane approximates a line running from the upper two-thirds of the pad to the incisal edges of the maxillary teeth. Only the cusp tip of the maxillary teeth will occlude with the central groove of the mandibular teeth. Okay, let's watch Junior pose a set teeth. If he can do it, anyone can.